big, big night. I don't know about you, but I can't wait. Now, of course, I'm not talking about Game 4 of the Eastern Conference Finals with the Cavaliers on the verge of tying up the series at 2 games apiece. Can they cover the 7-point spread? It was 6.5 earlier today. Well, that's my 15-dime best bet tonight. No, I am talking about the reboot, the finals of American Idol tonight on ABC. That's what I am concerned about. It's a 3-way race. But I don't think Caleb, the country singer out of Dallas, Georgia, who's lost 85 pounds over the course of the season, I don't think he's going to be able to win it. Lackluster performance last night in the finals. I just don't think he's going to be able to win it. I think it's a 2-way race between Gabby and Maddie. Personal favorite is Gabby, the 18-year-old high school senior out of Pittsburgh. That's who I think is going to win it. But Maddie, outstanding rendition once again, a Fleetwood Mac's landslide last night. So I don't know. I'm going to be tuned in tonight watching it because, frankly, I've seen enough LeBron. Listen, this is what you come to this video report to get each and every day. You've got to get the important stuff. We can talk gambling any other day. This is the important stuff. You know, when American Idol first had its big, big run, I never watched it the first couple of seasons. But then my son, who was just a little boy at the time, he started watching it, and I thought, oh my God, I got to start watching American Idol. But then I realized it was like must-see TV because it was like destination programming. My wife, myself, and my son, in those years, starting when he was like 8, 9 years old up until, probably when he was like 13 and 14 until he left, you know, didn't have any interest anymore. It was like a great way for our family to spend like 4 hours a week together and do something together that he was totally involved in. And it actually came like one of our favorite things to do back in those days. And of course, when Steven Tyler came on and he was just like a monstrous, monstrous Aerosmith fan, it was like, yes, my son, like at 9 years old, was a huge, huge Aerosmith fan. I think it was the second concert I ever took him to. The first concert I took him to was Paul McCartney when he was 10 years old. The second one, I took him out to, I think it was Burkittsville, Pennsylvania, which is like on the border of West Virginia. I took him to an outdoor concert to see Aerosmith. And I think like the majority of the women who were in their 40s were dressing like it was still 1993. It was a bizarre sight. Yes, but that was the second concert I think I took my son to, and I think he's seen Aerosmith at least, well, he's seen Paul McCartney, I think, 5 times. I think he's seen Aerosmith at least 5 times. He's seen Bon Jovi, I think, 6 times, and thankfully I can say that I've never seen Bon Jovi once. And I hope to keep that record intact till the day I die. So we move forward. Let's talk about the NBA playoffs. That Steph Curry guy. He's really struggling, isn't he? As I said yesterday in the video report when I gave you the Warriors as a complimentary play, the law of averages always dictates that sooner or later it turns. And the Warriors had their day yesterday. And the Rockets, yeah, they weren't going to hold Steph Curry in check forever. And the fact that Kevin Durant single-handedly outscored the other 4 starters in game number 2 in that blowout loss at Houston, well, the law of average dictated, as I noted yesterday, that everybody else was going to get their act together when they returned home, the Warriors being the they, where they had won 15 straight playoff games, and you saw what happened. And the Rockets, once again, you have to think that little word that starts with an F. No. Get your minds out of the gutter. I'm not talking about that 4-letter word. No, I'm talking about that other word. Fraud might be applied to the Rockets when it comes to the postseason. Because once again, you have to go back to game number 2 and you have to say, did the Rockets win the game or did the Warriors lose the game? And again, the law of averages dictates that P.J. Tucker was not going to go 7-for-8 and score 23 points like he did when he averages only 6.2 points during the regular season. And you saw what happened yesterday when Trevor Ariza and P.J. Tucker returned to their norms. But hey, we'll talk more about the Warriors tomorrow. As I said, my 15-dime best bet tonight is actually back in baseball. Now, yesterday, had a customer, actually a guy who was a former customer, not even a customer anymore, but he's become a friend, wanted to know why I gave away the Warriors free yesterday. Because I love the Warriors. I gave you a winner on the Warriors. But to me, I thought the best bet was actually in baseball, where I had the fourth 20-dime raise the bar release in baseball since 2016 and cashed in with the Mets on the run line as a $1.20 dog in a 4-1 win over slump-ridden Arizona. Well, actually, listen, Not only was it a 20 dime play, but as a $1.20 dog, it was more valuable to me as a baseball play on the run line as a dog than the Warriors were. It doesn't matter where you make money. It doesn't matter as long as you make money. So to me, I don't care that I gave away the Warriors. And what I should have probably said in giving away the Warriors yesterday, I should have reminded you, and customers know this. Remember, guys, I have a 15 dime best bet on the series that I gave you, clients, and I have me down at minus 210 personally, so I'm 50% there, thanks to the Warriors' win yesterday. So I still had a vested interest in the Warriors winning yesterday's game because I have them as a series play, as a 15 dime best bet as well. Now, the one that has the big play tonight would be Steve Budin's Cali Cartel. Yesterday, they had their fifth straight 50 dime winner in the conference finals. They are 5-0, including a 3-0 sweep in this Eastern Conference series with a 50 dime play yesterday on the Warriors. Today, conference finals winners number 6 in a row, but this one twice as strong as any of the others. 100 dime basketball winner number 29 out of 45. They're game 4 lock, Boston and Cleveland, the side. You get it for over half price off by using coupon code CALI. C-A-L-I. FYI, all the NBA playoff crews that Budin has brought you over the past four postseasons combined are 61-37, and $10 bettors have won a combined $11,225 with their selections. So that is the featured play tonight in the NBA, and the featured play in baseball would be Brad Wilton, who's going for winning day number 7 out of 8. A third 109 best bet winner in 3 days after cashing with the Yankees on the run line yesterday, the Brewers plus 105 on Tuesday. And of course, he had 59 best bet total winners on Friday and Thursday. You got them all at discount. Same thing today. Get it over for half price off, saving $65 by using coupon code BRAD, B-R-A-D. All the other discount codes and promos are over on the homepage. For me, obviously, since I have the best bet on the side tonight, and I don't really have an opinion on the total, let me turn to baseball. With a team that I used in their last game out last Tuesday with this pitcher on the hill, and that would be the Minnesota Twins on the run line in a virtual pick'em game today at home against the Detroit Tigers. Once again, going with Jose Berrios, who had been in a slump, and then I used him in his last start because once again it was at home where he has excelled. And what did he do against St. Louis? 7 1/3 innings, 2 hits, 1 run, 10 strikeouts. So he's got a 3.10 earned run average in 5 starts this year, and that number is slightly skewed because he had one bad start. But in those 5 starts, opponents are batting just 181, and he struck out 33 batters and allowed just 19 hits in 29 innings of work. Now, those numbers should come of no surprise because last year, in 11 home outings at Target Field, 10 of them starts, he went 9-1 with a 2.41 earned run average, held opponents to a 199 batting average, had 69 strikeouts in 67 1/3 innings, and in those 67 1/3 innings, he only allowed 48 hits. Now, the Tigers are turning to a left-handed reliever, Blaine Hardy, 31-year-old southpaw, giving him his second career start. His first one wasn't bad. It was at home against Seattle on May 13th. He worked 4 1/3 innings, gave up 8 hits and 2 runs. But listen, the Tigers opened their road trip by losing 3 of 4 at Seattle over the weekend. They've scored just 11 runs in their last 5 games. They've only won 5 of their last 21 games on the road overall. Twins have been slumping. They won yesterday 3-1 over Milwaukee to snap a 3-game losing streak. The last game they had won prior to yesterday was the Tuesday start by Berrios at home against St. Louis. But I'm going to go with the Twins and Berrios. Lay the 1.5 runs. Take them into pretty much a pick'em situation today as your complimentary play. And that'll do it, guys. I wish you well. Watch American Idol tonight. Remember, you can vote till 9 o'clock Eastern Time. Vote for Gabby. Talk to you again tomorrow.